New Mexico appears to be making some progress when it comes to taking care of its youngest and most vulnerable residents. The latest Kids Count report from the Annie E. Casey Foundation ranks New Mexico 49th in the nation on more than a dozen key indicators of child well-being. Now, that's an improvement from dead last 2 years ago. And Giovanna, the report doesn't take into account the impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic because the numbers are from 2019. However, so what are your takeaways? Is this a good sign or just fool's gold here?
Well, you know, it's hard to really celebrate being 49th in the state, in the country. Mm-hmm. And we do keep, you know, swapping around 49th and 50th place. And so I understand, you know, the hard work that Voices for Children has been doing to, and other advocates to get the message out that, like, we are making some small improvements. Mm-hmm. I think the focus needs to be on what are we measuring and where is the support coming from?
Right.
You know, the indicators fall into four categories, education, health, economics, and family. Mm-hmm. And that's good, but, you know, a lot of those investments are only from the state. So there's just a lot going on here. And I think that the category of equity is not included anywhere. Mm-hmm. I know advocates, including Voices for Children, are doing amazing equity work. Mm-hmm. However, the Annie E. Casey Foundation and their whole national rubric for measuring everybody doesn't really do that yet, I don't think. Mm-hmm. And so that would be interesting to look at. You always have to look, you know, dig down into what are we really talking about here? What are we measuring? Mm-hmm. And to really say there have been some great things that the state has invested in, and we should also be asking the business community to invest. You know, it's not just the state that needs to be doing this. So I think it's not a huge cause for celebration, but it's good to dig down and see, you know, what are we really talking about here?
Right. You know, Ed Perea, I want to note again, the improvements are kind of tricky to kind of talk about here. We're talking about 2019. The 2020 numbers haven't even really come in. But the noted improvements in New Mexico are things like the percentage of kids living in poverty, teenage pregnancy rates, and the percentage of kids who have health insurance. All those things were improving, but how much of a difference is there really between a ranking of 49th and 55th and 51st, as Giovanna is saying? When can we start actually celebrating something here?
Gene, you know, I think we take all the improvements we can get in mm-hmm. whatever category there are, and for whatever the reasons are. We know when it comes to those children who have health insurance, with the expansion of Medicaid, that yep. brought those numbers down. You know, and I think, you know, we just want to make sure that we continue to improve. However, for as long as I can remember, we've always been 49th or 50th and back and forth. And the question has to be, why, generation after generation, do our numbers not change? Or something that really needs to be examined further? You know, we've heard the old saying, you know, thank goodness for Mississippi, because otherwise we'd always be last. And that's unfortunate. And, you know, as we've mentioned before, you know, 49th doesn't make us feel good as a community.
Ed, what would feel like progress to you personally? I mean, is there a number where you would say, you know what, guys, we're on track here? 45th, 40th, in the 30, you know, 38th? What's your number?
Well, unfortunately, you have your finite number 1 through 50.
Yeah.
And everyone, zero-sum game, someone, if you gain, someone else loses. And if you're looking at it sort of nationally, you wouldn't want anyone to go down in their rankings, but you would want your rankings to improve. Mm-hmm. So I think, you know, we need to set the rankings aside and actually take a look at what we're doing right and continue to improve wherever we are, and to set our goals and be very focused on achieving those goals. Mm-hmm. And one step at a time. I think, you know, we have four categorical areas that we've seen some improvement. There are probably reasons for it, and we need to find the other areas and really have a laser focus on what we need to do to improve, whether it's resources or whether it's philosophy. But 49th, 50th, 48th, 47th is not acceptable in my personal opinion. So I think we need to look at the bigger picture as well. Mm-hmm.
Serge, you're the educator here, certainly. What does it do that we seem to fluctuate year to year between these bottom three spots? Does it show that we're not thinking big enough about our kids, as Ed was sort of getting at? It can't be just about throwing more money at the problem. What else are we missing here from an educator's point of view?
Yeah, so, I mean, I think, you know, these numbers are, they don't tell us much, right? Okay. The ranking. And maybe to some extent represent just sort of statewide economic well-being. Mm-hmm. I think, you know, you asked the question whether philosophy was an important metric. And I think the answer is yes. Mm-hmm. Statewide, we've had, you know, we're on our ballot next year will be a constitutional amendment to tap the permanent fund for early childhood mm-hmm. education. That's a real shift, or should be, right? A real yep. shift in how we approach this, you know, in New Mexico, the philosophy. Right now, the Yazzie Martinez lawsuit, the state is still fighting that and pushing back instead of saying, mm-hmm. yes, we totally embrace this obligation. Mm-hmm. There's a real, I think philosophically we should say, we are actually gonna pull out all the stops and do everything we can to address childhood well-being, at the front end, rather than wait till we get another report. And then right. if we're doing that, who cares what the number is? Like we said, you know, I don't want to root for any other state to go below us. Right? You know, I want us all to be tied for number one.
I hear you.
But, mm-hmm. you know, right. But I think New Mexico should be doing more of what it can do. And we're trending in that direction a little bit. Mm-hmm. And this should be a wake up call, as every year.
Sure. Giovanna, please.
Yeah, I was going to add to that, Serge, and just say there was a great reporting by Alicia Guzman at Searchlight New Mexico. She did a really nice story about this and really talked about the inequities. And, you know, when we look at the Yazzie Martinez lawsuit and the focus on at-risk kids, I love how Alisa Deal, who's an attorney with the New Mexico Center on Law and Poverty, talks about that population, saying it's New Mexico's truly diverse and culturally gifted student population. And if we center them and their diverse and cultural gifts, I think we have a different approach. And so it's a matter of, like, what are we centering in the conversation? Mm. And definitely taking a look at that would be a good idea.
That's a good point. I really appreciate the way you finished that up. It's who's out there with the big ideas? I mean, this is what we're looking for. It's a difficulty. We're going to stay on this right here at New Mexico in Focus, no doubt about it. Now.